Okay.
Some of the lobbyists will lose the job, that's all.
Okay, Prabhu, what changes from here? Because there are politicians, there are top ministers, the prime minister's office has been involved trying to mediate. We know the finance minister has been very concerned about the fight that's going on. There are bureaucrats involved, as you said, lobbyists involved. So there's an entire industry, a huge industry that's been built up in keeping this feud going. How do things change in Delhi?
You see, it would happen when Dhirubhai was alive. He was running the whole show. Not with, you see, as you know, the government is also divided between one brother and the second brother. If somebody was writing a letter against one brother, they will accuse, okay, we can't do anything for you because somebody has written a letter against you. So these two brothers will now flank themselves against any adverse publicity or fight against each other. Now the government ministers can't speak against each other. The problem is for the politicians who were milking the brother fight for their own benefit. Ultimately, bureaucracy, sorry to say, media, part of us, and the politicians, they are going to ultimately suffer. And these brothers are going to take on their rivals who are benefiting from non-communication between the two brothers. Now they can find out easily that who is writing letters to the government against Anil or against Mukesh. So there will be some kind of a truce for the time being, and anybody buying into each other's company, I don't think that will happen. Because the other point which I want to make here, if they want to protect the third generation. Mm-hmm. Because boys are getting there, they're in the college, 2-3 years from now, 4 years from now, sons of both the brothers will take over some of the businesses. They love each other, they stay same in the same building, they are building the basis for the third generation to work together as family rather than fighting with each other. So it will take that much of time so that they can settle for the third generation. That's a long-term perspective which is happening, and the grandmother wants to assure the grandson at least live peacefully. Therefore, father must settle for now.
Sandeep, give our viewers a sense of the pivotal role played by Kokilaben Ambani, the mother of these two warring brothers, in bringing them together, because she's the one who's literally held the reins and forced them willy-nilly to come together and work together.
If you go back to June 18, 2005, then what is it that she wanted to drive? She wanted to drive a fair and equitable settlement without dividing the flagship, which in this case was Reliance Industries. You could not vertically divide Reliance Industries because that would have catastrophic consequences on the market, on corporate India, etc., etc. So, in lieu of not dividing Reliance Industries, gas was given for 17 years and a formula was devised, and that was to compensate for the non-division of Reliance Industries. Now, if gas was not given, and that overhang of that gas became the genesis of the whole problem. So you had a situation where they fought tooth and nail, they took each other to court. Once they went to the Supreme Court and a Supreme Court verdict came out, then there was no court of appeal. That's it, door closed. So from there on, I think the mother, who was distraught with all the bitterness and acrimony over the years, would have probably told them that here and now is the time to resolve our differences. And I think we tend to forget that this business, the Reliance empire, was not vertically divided 50-50. Mm-hmm. It was divided, the mother and the two sisters are also shareholders, and large shareholders. And I think that particular point needs to be factored into any equation when it comes to whatever is going to happen.
Okay.
You see, we wrote the story. I think he has made a point. Let me explain what was the allocation. The valuation was done of the entire group. And since Reliance could not be divided, Arcom was given back to Mukesh Ambani because that valuation was 25,000 crore rupees at that point of time. And there Mukesh Ambani didn't have 25,000 crore.
So he gave
it was, distribution was 30% Anil Ambani, 30% Mukesh Ambani, 30% mother, 10% to both the sisters. That was the division at that point of time, which was decided internally.
Okay.
Now it is being decided how to go about it. They are not going to buy it in each other. It's a valuation at that point of time. And gas was also in lieu of the valuation which was conducted at that point of time.
Okay. Mr. Bajaj, there are executives involved over here. The brothers are involved. There's a lot of bad blood. For the last 5 years, the top executives at ADAG and in RIL have spent a lot of their time and energy plotting and scheming against each other. We've seen people who've got split up, relatives have got split up across business empires. Will these people, the executives, sir, be able to get together and work together once again? Because there's just so much bad blood. Can it just be given up if the brothers ask? What sense do you make of that, sir?
It's a valid question and a valid point. When let's say brothers disagree or fight, obviously people with them, their relatives, the top executives take sides. The junior executives don't matter really. But very often you will find that the relatives, the sensible relatives, and the sensible top executives, mention it openly. Listen, they tell this fellow, you're fighting him, or they tell him you are fighting him, but you will make up tomorrow, and we will be left by the wayside. We don't want to take sides as far as possible, because we are loyal to the company and not to an individual. Now, a lot of people feel that way, and that's why they will not, Anil's side, I don't know Mr. Jhunjhunwala and some others, or Mr. Doshi, but I do know Hitel Meswani, Nikhil Meswani, Anand Jain, on the side of Mukesh, but I'm sure a lot of them, in the heart of heart, felt that way, told their boss, their friend, that come on, what will happen to us tomorrow? The question which you asked, Rahul. But having said that, there may be a few who went out of the way to hurt the other. And all I can say is, it could take time to put that right, and it's for the other, whoever it is, to also forgive and forget. Because let's not force either brother to let go his trusted, most trusted lieutenants.